Hi, I'm Saito Katsunori, a professional photographer. Today I'll be showing you how to adjust targeted areas of a picture using Nikon NX Studio's color control points. Here we have a photo of cherry blossoms in the same frame as Mount Fuji. The sky is always hazy in cherry blossom season, so its colors just don't pop. Here is where I'll use color control points to target just the sky part of the picture and make it pop. We'll start by clicking Touch Up in the Adjustments palette, and then Color Control Point, which displays this dialog. Clicking this icon in the Color Control Point tool changes the cursor like this. I can now click the picture to add a color control point to the bit I want to change. Then, I can click this triangle to view the sliders for the different parameters you see here. The same parameters are listed in the Adjustments palette. First, I'll use the Size slider to adjust the size of the area affected. Next, I'll use an Adjustment slider to reduce brightness of the sky and heighten color. Now, I'll boost saturation a bit. With these adjustments, the sky's colors are starting to pop. I'll go on to adjust the other areas of the sky in the same way. For that, I can right-click the current control point to display this menu, where I'll click Duplicate Control Point. That creates a copy of the control point, which you can then drag to a new position. And again, you can right-click and select Duplicate Control Point to create another identical copy. That's how you can change a hazy sky into a sky with colors that pop. But if you look closely, you'll notice the clouds are a little blue. Let's try restoring the clouds to their original color. I'll place a control point where the clouds have turned blue. I don't have to do anything else, just place the control point. That restores the clouds that have turned blue to their original color. Just adding a color point reduces the first area of effect. Let's try adding color points to other areas where the colors have changed. I'll put another one here. What do you think? Let's compare it with how it looked before. We can see the unedited version by unchecking this box. As you can see, placing a control point changed what was at first a hazy sky to a very beautiful blue. Moving on, let's try editing another picture using color control points. This picture was framed to blur the tulips in the foreground. This, however, gives the picture an extremely dark and gloomy feel, because the blurred tulips in the foreground are dark. Here, we'll try using color control points to brighten the foreground. First, open the Control Color Point tool in the Adjustments palette and click this icon. Next, place a color control point in the dark area. The first step is to choose the size of the area affected. Then, we'll increase brightness. You can see that the area is now brighter. Brightening the tulips has made the colors slightly less vivid, so let's adjust saturation a bit. I'll do the same on the right. As before, I'll right-click the control point in the display and click Duplicate Control Point here. That creates a copy of the control point, which I'll drag to the right. And we're done! Let's compare it with how it looked before. How's that? Not only is the dark and gloomy feel gone, but the photograph we have now is bright and vivid. So, what do you think? With color control points, targeted adjustments are a snap. Why not give them a try?